Hey guys, it's your boy Crypto Prison, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Chroma, where last time I left off, I picked up in our win in the Champions League, and a win in the league, you know, the standard stuff. And yeah, following on from that episode, I have a game in the Capital One Cup up against Plymouth. And I think my league game is against Sunderland? I think it's Sunderland, because I played Newcastle in the last episode. Yeah, it is. It is Sunderland, unless it's changed. But, the last episode, it was coming up as Sunderland in a league game. So, yeah. It could have been changed, but unless I didn't get attention to it, including these two, more teams, clubs taking this competition seriously,
wouldn't you? It's a great one to lift at the end of it.
Game today, Liverpool against Plymouth Argyle. Liverpool hoping for another win. They played well last time out. They won at home against Newcastle.
4-0. The manager would have been delighted.
See how the what lineup I've gone with for this
big reshuffle
with the second team.
Ilori plays with Vallejo in defence, and leading the attack today, Emre Moore. And he goes for goal with his head.
Can we play on? Yeah, the advantage. Emre Moore takes full advantage, and in the third minute, he makes it 1-0. That's the power of playing advantage.
As many as we used to of it, but the cross made the header so possible.
Yeah, it is still one of the best sights in football.
And normally, when I play a team from a lower division, they are very defensively sound. And I find it hard to break them down. And so most of the time, needing like a late winner to get them. But nice early goal this time. That's a good start.
And they talk of him taking on some international commitments as well.
Interesting. I mean, he's clearly a talented club manager. Now, managing an international side is a little different, but I think he's
so for a fancy.
Attacking well here. And in goes the cross. Goes for goal with the header. So close with that header.
Oh, he's good at that, isn't he? He really does.
I really thought that might be 2-0. I was actually waiting with faded breath to say 2-0, but
I almost think he thought he'd scored.
Canu will put it just wide of the post. Come on, Valencia, win that header.
Calabria.
Alexander Arnold.
Nicely played through ball. Marvellous tackle.
The pressure on. Really? How did you not come away from that with the ball? It's absolutely my
error, really. Able to ease the pressure by that interception. It's Smith.
Now I'm starting to wonder will Plymouth hold on to a 1-0 loss.
Fizzled out here, goal kick. I mean, and it'll go into the middle now. Cross is blocked.
They wouldn't. I can't imagine they'd be happy to lose, but if they did, my lose if they were accepting the fact that they. Have, let's be honest, next to no chance to beat me. Wonder wouldn't be a bad scoreline.
It's impairing a bit our visibility of the proceedings out there on the pitch.
Yeah, we're not.
The goalkeeper comes out with a punch.
Come on. Wobble in. Moya! Aye.
Aye. attacking now.
Where?
Great stop.
How did that not go in? The post! The keeper was practically off his line. Well, he was off his line. All I had to do was get that on target, and it's in the back of the net, and it's 2-0. But I hit the post.
Well, he could have kept the ball, but he didn't. He made that look like a poor pass with a very good interception. On the attack here. And the cross is in. That was a good crossing position, but not a good cross.
Fernandez. Oh, come on, Moore. Use that pace.
Wonderful chance.
Come back.
That shot's blocked.
Moya. Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
Throw in for Liverpool. Could be dangerous. They stopped the ball coming in. Deflected behind. A clear corner. What about that chance?
First, that still goes down as a shot on target.
Here's the header.
Hey.
Gap between reserve team football these days and the first team, but he's been doing well for the reserves and he's got himself a game here.
Well, I think he deserves a chance, Martin. If you do well for the reserves, he's shown a good attitude as well.
I'm not against it, but I always thought if it hit the post, that's off target.
Now the shot. A little too eager to get in.
It wouldn't have mattered if that had gone in because it was offside.
Look across the line.
And I knew full well it was offside.
Well, it is Liverpool's match at this point, but there's a lot more of it still to go, and they'll be wondering whether they're good enough to see this through. Plenty of time left, all of the second half, of course. Now, Vallejo. Carey. We've got 4 more minutes to play. Added time here.
4 minutes. Ah. What was the frickin' point?
Osborne.
It looks like it's going to be 1-0 at half time. Referee will blow here any second now. There he is. Well,
the referee has signaled for half time, and it's 1-0 here. Well, this could be the halfway point in the cup tie.
1-0 at half time. Not ideal, but I'll take it. At least I'm winning.
Really good contest this for a place in the quarterfinals of the English League Cup, but still a second half to go, and here it is.
I do want to get a second goal in the second half, just to
short passes, keeping the ball,
make it so one goal.
The break is definitely on.
Won't make the scoreline equal. And here's the second goal. Well, easy as you like for Moya. Moore gets a goal and an assist.
A bit more comfortable. Value for this advantage at the moment. He's an impetuous goalkeeper, this one, and it's cost him here.
Well, he did go AWOL, but the scorer was Johnny on the spot to make him pay. Good finish.
Lifted it into the back of the net. And it's 2-0. Well, that's his second goal of the competition.
2-0.
Is it from where?
Osborne.
That's exactly what I wanted. Two early goals. Was one early in the first half, and the second early in the second half.
I could have got through there, but the defender was absolutely on top of his game. Smith. There's going to be a substitution. It's for the away team.
We're only going to get early.
Look how quick he reacted.
Yes, goals. Was at the beginning of each half that would indicate I was going to say that would indicate that the scoring is over, but Plymouth disagree. He, with a very good goal from David Goodwin. Really. He makes it 2-1.
They look the team on the up now.
And we restart the game 2-1.
Gotta try it.
Oh my god, how did I miss that?
Can we have another look at the goal, yes?
Come on, win the header.
Manager,
or don't.
For the away side, time for a change.
Smith for Plymouth. Gives it to Jarvis.
They spread it out wide here. Chance to get some width into this.
It's easy for you.
It's the goalkeeper's ball. Coming up for you on EA Sports.
Hey, look.
Don't miss this. The coverage of the Premier League.
They agree with me. Think that the Sunderland game should be next.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it.
But this game has a habit of change. Well, not a habit, but it's done it twice before where I said one particular match was coming up and then it was changed.
It's looking good, this move. Shots on here. What a fine save.
I wasn't too sure where to take
it. Moment for them.
If we're granted or say, yeah, that's definitely the next match.
That is,
but as it turns out,
the keeper, quite rightly, is disgusting.
Looks like it is definitely the next match, which I will go into the quarterfinal of the League Cup as Moya scores his second of the game to make it 3-1. Very nice.
Just a reminder, 3-1 it is now, the scoreline. Still 20 minutes to go. It's a good way to nick the ball back. Quick thinking. Promising build-up until that challenge.
Suddenly, a game that had only one goal in all of the first half has had three goals in the second.
Some players limbering up for the away team.
And the second half is still 15 minutes away from being over. So there's time for more goals, if possible. Plymouth will certainly hope so, and probably Moya as well. Probably hope that there's another, at least one more goal in this, considering now he's on a hat trick.
Quality down there in the way that he's manipulating that ball and starting moves.
The substitute coming on to try and repair the damage now. That is a cheap piece of play to give the ball away like that. It is Liverpool's day, it seems. Barring any late slip-ups, they have been the team in control. Well, we've only got 7 minutes remaining now. 3-1 here, and that could be that, really, given the lack of time left. What do you think for the next game?
Ozo.
Well, Liverpool go up against, and he could get
away here. Can he make it 4-1, get his second in the game? Yes, he can.
Could have come out.
That definitely ends Plymouth's hope.
It might have been going wide initially.
Back into this game. They were briefly back into this game, but that was quickly and significantly rooted out before it planted any misideas into any Plymouth fans' heads.
So we restart again, 4-1.
Or gets his second of the game. I mean, now both my strikers are on hat tricks. But more importantly, Plymouth's revival, if you call it that, is thoroughly crushed.
3 minutes.
Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here.
More.
That's a good block.
We'll take the
team is
corner.
Lining up for the corner.
Well, his reaction would say he didn't want it.
Another shot.
Fernandez! Well, that would have been a gem. Fernandez trying to score something that would compete with Goodwillie's goal for best goal of the game. Acrobatic clearance, and that is the end of this cup tie.
Vallejo in defense.
He 4-1 it ends. Plymouth indeed could only get in the end a consolation goal. Ooh. At the time it seemed, when they scored it, it seemed like it might be a way back into the game. Nope. Wow. Other than me and Chelsea, all the other teams didn't score more than 2 goals. Freaky.
English League Cup. Cardiff City 2, Southampton 2. Cardiff City won 5-4 on penalties. Liverpool 4, Plymouth Argyle 1.
You are very welcome.
United 1, Watford 2.
If I read that correctly, I think the derby was just rearranged for when it was going to take place. I don't know when it was scheduled to happen, but apparently it's going to happen at a different time now. Well, look at the calendar. It's on the 8th. I think it was moved from the 9th, if I read it correctly. Wow. Look at that clusterfuck in December. Although, the game against the Wolves, and on the day that in real life I would be turning 23. I have to think, because it's 20, it would be 2018 in game, so I would be 23, because I'm 22 this year, or in December. And until then, I'm still 21. Anywho, ages aside, let's get in and play the Black Cats, shall we? If I can stop biting my own tongue.
Hi there, everybody. Martin Tyler here, along with the former Arsenal and England.
Stadium of Light. I feel like we should have a narrator today, Martin. Looking forward to it. Games like freaking games.
Features Sunderland play Liverpool.
Freaking talk show. Or SNL.
Running here with Sunderland starting the first.
Especially if you're gonna have live.
This is the second team for you today. Jan Kirchhoff plays alongside Lee Catamore in the middle of the park.
And they just go
up front. Big reshuffle for Liverpool. Lloris Karius is the goalkeeper. Daniel Klein starts. David Alaba as the fullbacks. Emre Can comes in for Roberto Firmino, who's
probably one of the most iconic ones.
The break is definitely on.
Television.
And shoots! Terrific stop! Matip! Great work by the goalkeeper.
He's
protected it. Liverpool getting it right at the back and building from that, building on the best defence.
No, I think the home side will have to produce something special to break through this defence.
Castaños. good position. They've worked this attack very well into a quite a dangerous position now. And here, it's the goalkeeper's ball.
Well, he was in the right place at the right time to cut it out.
Jan Kirchhoff.
Like
patience is the name of the game at the moment. Got the tackle in. Well, they passed their way up into a good position here. And then just lost the concentration.
Game?
Lost the ball as well. And they've got to work hard to try and get it back. Here's a chance to attack.
Turn a hold my breath.
Here's McNair.
Someone have a knack for scoring a goal against me and pissing me off.
It's Mane. On you go, says the referee to Sunderland. Fabio Borini.
Come on, give me the ball. Come on, Chancho. A little bit of strength. Ah, boy, damn it. Playing Origi. Yes. Divo Origi! Oh, what a save from Pickford. But Origi's going to get another shot. If he doesn't lose it first, which he did.
Well, they're going to start from the back because it's a back pass to the keeper. Catamo. He's read that, hasn't he, and made the interception, made it look easy, actually. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. Shot on! Good stop by the goalkeeper.
Oh, I don't know why I did. Went for that at long range.
Three draws in a row for today's hosts.
Hitting hope.
The goalkeeper can just saunter out and pick that up. Well, they're building steadily here,
God
working
say.
Away.
Aye.
He could cross it from here.
Fino.
Played into the middle. They cope with it well defensively.
Kone has to put it behind. We've for the corner. Couldn't, seemingly couldn't take the risk with Mane and Origi lurking. Ah, Matip, take it with you next time, man. Oh, Origi wins it and gets into Mane, but Pickford does enough. What a prick. And Götze's attempt is terrible.
When he's hit it, I'm sure he would have thought that was going to bulge in the back of the net. Not quite, though.
I was kind of hoping it would dip, but it didn't dip. Ah.
This is how they love to play on the break.
Origi, 1-0. There we go. That's much better. 2 minutes. Or on the stroke of half time.
Because they're now into the lead.
Divo Origi. He ever since ousting Daniel Sturridge from.
Well, they're celebrating Liverpool here.
Spot.
Not just the nature of the goal, but the timing of it.
Yeah, I think so. There's nothing better just before half time. You go in, you're happy, and you're going to go for that second half.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
Goal for Liverpool.
Perfect end to the first half to get my nose in front.
That's half time at 1-0.
As if to pile on that misery.
Just a couple of minutes to repair
the Sunderland even more. The referee almost immediately blew for the half time break. Just to emphasize, yeah, they just dealt you a metaphorical kick to the nuts, and I'm going for half time, so enjoy that. Let it fester over half time. What a dick. Well, that's Clattenburg.
And Liverpool
so
replicate. Good for
I think I'm period, I have fair right to call him a dickhead. I think never.
Well, it's an important area to win back the ball. That
Lee Catamon. I think there's a goal to tell you about from Alan McAnally at the Emirates.
It's a second goal for Crystal Palace.
And shoots!
Riggy!
Oh, he was away. Alamy was clear.
Well, it looked like the perfect counter-attack. The whole defence had been beaten, but, well, the keeper wasn't.
Just over the bar. Of course. Come on, in the header.
And that news from Alan McAnally that we had to interrupt.
Sadio Mane.
Crystal Palace. The score's 2-1. Corner given after that tackle.
I wish they would update and play him to Crystal Palace. Then that would severely weaken Sunderland.
We can see it again. Alan Smith. That's the goal that's given them the lead.
Well, he took a real swing at that ball and it's flown off his boot into the top left.
I don't understand why he made that switch in
real
life.
A real treat in store for you. Coverage,
I mean, he's
on EA Sports.
Created a
Sunderland, they'll be
all but doomed to relegation team for another all but doomed to relegation
going
team.
For goal, having scored in the game,
so
this one has passed him by.
Yeah, I don't think you can knock him for having a go from there. Yeah. He was in a good position.
I guess depending on results, Palace might survive to fight longer than Sunderland will. I don't know. We'll see. But the two of them seem like they're both going down. Which must delight Newcastle fans to all. Well,
Coutinho. Yes. Possibility.
Three.
For it.
Ah. Should have put more power into that to catch people off guard. But, I put very little power into it because why the hell?
To punch it away. Shot on. Oh, it's over the top.
Couldn't have driven that shot low.
In their next match.
You freaking launched.
I think this could be pretty easy for them.
Like it's a fucking rocket. Thanks, Nicholas. That was a big help.
Ready to make a move in terms of a substitution now. And it is a goal kick.
Ah.
Activity on the bench for the losing team. A substitute getting ready to come on.
Taking off one player I've never heard of for another player I've never heard of. Sunderland's team has drastically changed.
Piece of attacking play from Sunderland.
Season so far.
Brilliant football from this team.
They're 2-0 almost. Almost 2.5.
And now he's looking for some support. Just a quick check.
Rapidly closing in on the halfway point of this season. Penalty!
Patrick Van Aanholt.
That's not a penalty. Bench. I mean, yeah, he was a bit dramatic about it, but Shan was definitely fouled. Two questionable refereeing decisions. Oh, yeah, but you give that one. You give that. Oh, but the foul on Shan. Oh, completely fucking ignore that. Great job, Plattenberg, you. Fucking asshole. Yeah, as I was saying, three questionable refereeing decisions in two videos. If you did not see, if you're wondering what I'm talking about, you didn't see the video that went up yesterday, the secondary career mode video. All I'm gonna say is, what a load of crap. What a load of bullshit.
Liverpool, we could be in.
I show the ball going over the line, and it was not given.
Here, 9 to go. He's got his shot off now. It's a fine strike, but not quite what he was hoping for.
But when he's hit it, I'm sure he would have thought that was going to bulge in the back of the net. Not quite, though.
That.
It's too close to call this, but they've still got a one-goal advantage.
Well, the atmosphere. Win the header, yes.
Now the home team need to improve. They're still in with a shout.
Yeah, time is running out. It's now or never. I think they've got a good game.
Well, that looked promising, but he's been stopped.
Now play from the back. Nathaniel Klein.
The numbers come up. The break is dead.
Sadio Mane. 4 minutes. And get into the position. In for the... I was trying to get it across to... freaking Regan, the Sunderland keeper.
It's so frustrating for them. They're on the attack. They can't break through.
There, that Karius.
And that's the final whistle.
Don't look so disappointed. It's only 1-0, yes, but it's still a win.
Clearly underdogs. Now they'll be pretty happy with the way they played.
I think so.
Why does the Sunderland manager look like Ronald Koeman?
Performance moving forward.
He's not the Sunderland
got the result
manager.
They wanted.
Anyone else find that weird? It looked a lot like him.
Arsenal.
I mean, is that
Crystal
supposed
Palace
to be
two.
David Moyes? Because that's who the Sunderland manager is.
City one.
You know, just for the record.
Middlesbrough 3, Sunderland 0, Liverpool 1, Swansea City 2.
I don't need to look that up. I know that for sure.
West
Ham, I don't think he's been sacked.
Manchester City 2. Now let's see what effect that's had on the league standings. At the top of the table remain Liverpool with 30 points.
Both really
in second, Manchester City with 22 points. In third, West Bromwich Albion with 17 points. In fourth, West Ham United with 16 points. In fifth, rising up the table are Manchester United with 14 points. In sixth, Chelsea with 13 points.
Really
in
close.
Seventh, moving down, are Sunderland with 13 points.
Fernandez,
in eighth,
Renato
climbing
Sanchez.
The table, are Crystal Palace with 13 points.
Hmm.
Bottom of the table, Derby County
he would
with
be,
1 point.
It would
and
be
then
wasting.
Reading up the table, second
what
bottom,
it?
Middlesbrough with 8 points. Third bottom, Aston Villa with 9 points.
He might go up naturally.
Fourth bottom, Newcastle United with 9 points.
December,
fifth bottom, Hull City with 9 points.
Fernandez could use the boost. I like how Fernandez's picture looks completely different to his in-game avatar. Anyone else notice the new pictures for the for some of the players? Calabria doesn't look like freaking best impersonator of the guy who plays Leonard on The Big Bang Theory. Now he looks like a really discounted Ethan Carter III. You wrestling fans will know him. Non-wrestling fans are like, who? Look it up. Fort would like to discuss wages. Yes, I can do that. But that will be done in, well, I'll do that off camera. And we'll see if he accepts it in the next episode. Until then, thanks for watching. I'm Andre. Smash the like button if you did, subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.